complete fuselage seat. So I will take one by one, keep the other things out. Clean it all the way. So it contains a lot of parts. If you take the fuselage, we have main fuselage part, you can find. This is the main fuselage part here. Here this is the upper canopy, this is the lower one. You'll find all the things. Okay, now see, this is your main fuselage body. This is the middle strap which you have to insert in the fuselage body. And this is the upper canopy and the canopy that is we have to place. This is the top and lower part. And this one is the motor mounting, motor canopy. So we will go later on stage these things. So first of all, I will try to assemble the fuselage only. So you just remove these two part, that is for sliding the wings. Next, what you have to do, you remove this middle parts all, which is cut half. Go on, remove all the foams. Just this will be both the side. You have to remove in the same manner all the foams. If any foam left, you have to remove through the blade. This small part is left, that means I will use my blade to remove this. I cannot place this because it is helpful for attaching the glue. Same thing you do in this side also. You just remove the foam. Okay, go and remove all the sides wherever 50% cut mark is there. Right. Next part, here also some part you have to remove. There are 50% mark is there, you have to remove the foam. This also you have to remove. You can use your blade. Okay, for removing this part. So after removing all the part, you will find this is the fuselage. There is another thing I have to remove here. I have to place the strap, that you can use your barbecue sticks for removing this middle also. Use your barbecue sticks, slowly go on, remove. Fine. So any foam left, that also you try to remove. Same thing you do for this side. This is already cut out. Only you have to remove the foam properly. Fine, it is removed completely. Next, this part have to go in this vanner. You have to slide like this. In between the slot, you have to slide in this manner. So first make it dry fit properly. So here is a little bit foam is there. Any foam left you have to remove. Okay, next I will go for fitting this metal strap. In between this, go on sliding. So I will use my glue gun. Put all together. This is enough. This side. Glue. Then slide it all around. See, the lower part will be go the bottom side and the upper part will be go upper side. Like this it have to place. Make it a proper manner so that hold it, keep it in this manner just for a few minutes. And the upper side should not come from other side. So it will be simple. You can observe it should not come from any side. It is just flat surface it have to. So like this you have to hold for a few minutes like this. It should be very flat. So hold it for a few minutes. Okay, now it is dry. This is the place you can slightly marking also you can find. So next part you have to remove is the beef fold. See this foam I have to remove before attachment of this. Fine. So this is a beef fold like this. And this will be exactly fit into this part. In this way it have to go. So this is the way, and here this will be the upper part. So with the dry fit check you have to do first before going for the hot gun glue. You have to go for first dry fit fitting. So it's fine. It looks very fine. So I will use the glue in this side. And this side. And here in the slot. Okay. Once it's over, you can go for fitting in this manner. And slide all around like this. Hold it for 9 degrees. See, you can use the set square for checking the perpendicularity like this. It should be perfectly 90 degrees. Check it in this manner, the 9 degree perpendicularity. Hold it for a few minutes. Once it is dry,
now it is covered a little bit. Now you go through the tail part. You can take the glue. It's too hot. So one by one you try to attach here a little bit. So I will try to attach this side.
all the side you attach better. You observe I am giving the side only glue, not to the bottom. Then you take this one side first, you do like this, try to attach all around to the end, right to the end. Hold it for few minutes, it will stick. You can observe this side I am sticking. Wait till it stick properly. Okay, now it is almost thick. Now take it little bit more all the side. Along the edges you give more. Okay. So here is, you can use this part, insert the glue. So just fix on this side, then you can attach in this way also. Take the glue, I'll use a little bit more. You can have this part little bit glue. All the edges, along the edges I'm giving glue. Take a deprom. Just all around. Remove any extra glue present. Similarly, this side also. On the tail side, you can start. Okay, use the deprom to keep it on position. So this part I have attached this line. This you can attach. Now the upper part will go like this. So go for try fit first like this. So next what I have to do, I'll use the gun. All around you apply glue. I want a little bit more, so I'm holding my sticks. And similarly you apply this side so that it will stick properly. It is so hot, it will stick definitely good. So what I'll do, whatever I've done previously, first I'll hold it one side, then you stick the upper side. That is very nicely stick, you can observe. So hold it, you can use any deprom piece I am using for tightening this two part. Slower part is important. So holding with this, hold it for few minutes, it will stick like this. Now the upper part is lower part of the fuselage is over. So we will move to
upper one here. You can observe this is almost coming down, so we will go for attaching this lateral stays. So first of all, I will try to attach this part, little bit glue in this corner, so that it will good tight fitting I will obtain. So next thing is what I have to do, take this upper canny beam, you have to place like this. So just remove this this part, you can observe it have to hold just before this, in this manner it have to hold, so like this you have to hold like this. So I will go for fitting the lower part in this manner. So I will take the glue on, apply the glue all around. Only in order to get more glue, I will apply the holding the sticks I am applying, so that more glue can come here in this side also, a little bit to the corner. Now this what you have to do, go on pressing all around, hold, use your table like this, see, like this I am holding, use your table, hold it properly, hold it till the glue dry up. So this is the place situation, you have to press in this manner. See. Hold it till the glue will be dry. Okay, so it is almost thick. See, it have to be a perfect square. So here, other things you have to do.
Before attaching the upper part, you have to go for the landing gear attachment. In landing gear, you will find the landing gear, this motor mounting and landing gear box. Two wheels. So, for example, first, this two poro plastic seat, first we have to do, you can place somewhere here, one direction, either this side, like this, you have to place. In this order, and then you have to place the motor mounting like this. You have to place, it is exactly fitting. So it is somewhere here, you can place where the cutting is taking place, in this place where you can place somewhere, so there is not a big issue in which direction you will place. So you check it, if it is little bit more or in this way also you can place, no problem. So I will go with in this direction, because it will be here, we'll get a little bit nice fitting, and this motor mounting is going to fit here. So this is the way you have to do, exactly it will fit, it will fit here, right, along with the boxes. It will be, you have to place like this. In this way it will fit. So before going to that, I will place this. So take a hot gun and give sufficient glue all around, apply. So sufficient glue came. So just I am placing this all around. Then now I place this in this manner. Okay. hold it like this, press it little bit more. Next step, what you have to do, we have to use this wooden landing gear attachment, because if it is not there, the two screws have to go inside this. So what you have to do, you use somewhere here, anywhere in middle, you can roughly can take in the middle, you can see. I given the glue all around. This I'm using this flexi fix, because this coroplastic is a flexi one. So let's see, make it straight a little bit. Once you feel it is straight, just press it for more time, put it for more time. It will take the shape, and the sticking between the coroplastic and wood is very strong. It will not come out easily. So hold it for 1 minute. It will dry up. Okay. So in this way, now it is attached. So what you have to do next step, there is also a coroplastic stick which is going in this now, in this direction. So that the landing gear just give the same place like this wherever wood is attached. So wood is attached somewhere here, so in this direction I have to place somewhere. So same manner I will do, I will use my hot gun. So I will use a lot of glue to come out. Okay, so I'm using a lot of glue. Next, what I have to do, okay, so you fix it here. Somewhere in between this, you can observe somewhere here I'm fixing. Just hold it little bit. Later on you can give in the gap, you have to provide hot glue. You have to create a hole between them so that you can insert the screw and attach the landing gear. So that I will go. So first what I will do, I will use this candle. I can have a matches. I use this candle. It will be hot a little bit. I'll make this hot so that I can insert the screw. So once it is hot, I can insert in between these two holes to create a hole. See, here I'm inserting. In this minute it is coming out. Similarly, other side also, other hole also, I will make. Right here also. So these are the two holes. Okay, so this all. Next, what you have to do, in your packet you will find the setup screw, that is here, the setup screw where you have a landing gear screw and the other motor mounting screw. So I will take two small screw like this, two screw along with the washer, two washer I am taking. And two, this is 13th screw. So I'll place like this, in this manner, just like this. Same thing I will repeat for other screw also. So same manner, I placed the two screw. Okay. So the screw a little bit small, but can insert the landing gear. Take this screw, little bit bend the screw like this. It is around 30 mm, so it will come like this. Similarly, take another washer. The two set of screw are there. This bigger one is for landing gear. This is smaller one. This is 25 inches for motor mounting. So take the 30 mm screw and then apply this. Okay. So this is the two side it will come. Next, what you have to do? Just press. Use little bit glue here, so that it will not come further. So just use a little bit glue, not much. This side also, little bit glue, and you can use a barbecue sticks or something. I using a pen. Just press it so that the screw will be remain pressed, or you can use a this screwdriver also. Just hold in this so that it will remain in press tight. Fine. Once it is pressed, now you can have this landing set. You can apply this side, right? You can apply in this direction, in this manner. Okay. Once it is have, there is a 3 mm screw. You'll find screw. Fine. Just apply the screw. Apply the screw. Then you can tie it easily. Fine. Next, in the screw packet also you will find there is a 50 mm screw. Two set of screw is there. So take one screw, go in this direction, right? Then use one screw here. Okay. Then take your clasp and tighten this and tighten the screw. Tight, and you can use this hot screw, this flex so that it not come. But now at present I am not using. But before you can use this. Similarly, then you can go for this reel and place like this. See. The wheel is moving in this direction. You can use a this small strip of zinc tube, which is this in this packet you will find a small strip of zinc tube. Take it, cut small part, right, and use a little bit small. See, as a landing gear collar I am using like this, and then you can use the lighter. Here, right, then it will not come out, but still you can use this little bit. If you put it, will stick here and it will not come further. So same thing you repeat for.
Okay, so already I have fixed the other wheel, you can see.
So next thing, so we go for this head part. I can apply a little bit glue so that it should not come further. Next, I will attach this upper one. This corner. Okay, before that, I have to use the motor mount. See, motor mounting, you will find a piece like this. So, first you use this motor mounting. Later on, I will go for this fixing of this part. So, So I'll keep it in one side. So in motor mounting, you'll find this piece. So take this, remove the middle part. This thing, and this also you remove the middle part, right? Here also you can have this thing cut. Then the object is that this two piece you keep it, you will use later on stage, this two piece. So here the fixing will be like this. It will be go up. It will fix exactly in this manner here, exactly in the same dimension. So in this manner. So for that, it will go up. Okay, it is in this manner. It will fix. So this is the way it will fix. So before fixing this, we use the glue. Put all around the glue. Upper one, this side, and this all around to fix the glue. Can use more like this. Okay, so first take it this two up. Next, this will be in the side, holding all the side. Then press this two part. This two clear minutes here. Press it this way. Hold it for a few minutes. So it will be looks in this manner. Right, so it will exactly fit in this direction. So just little bit back for motor mounting in this direction. And our motor mounting will find these things and it will fix here. So, okay. So what you will do, I will take this two part which is coming out. See, take it from this side. It will be fixed like this, in this way. Take half of the seat like this. One corner you can place one. Just at the edge you can place like this. And another corner. See, it have to touch here. Completely it have to touch here. Right? So first you take a glue gun, and apply it here. What I'll do, I'll take this glue and all around I'll press in this side and this side and in this side, all around I'm pressing, and then I'll place here in between this, just I'll place some space for motor mounting. It have to place in between here, so give a space for this so that it can pass like this exactly. So next, what you have to do, in this way you have to place, hold it tightly so that the glue will stick to the dapron. Then keep it as parallel as possible. Then take this two piece, whatever you have cut before, apply glue this side as well as this side, both side you apply glue, and then this corner you place, the end you place. Okay, so should be as parallel as possible. I told like this. Hold it tightly. Similarly, this side also. One side it will give slightly towards right. This side you place it will, the motor mounting will find slightly towards right, just to overcome the right thrust vector or the prowess. So let it stick properly. Now in this case, it just provide the glue, sufficient glue, so that it will stick to other surface. Fine. Now it is stick. Now the motor mounting can offset slightly towards this side. Hold it for a few minutes. Okay, fine. Once it is over, now you can go for the upper part like this. It can fit like a box, complete box. Right, in this way you have to fix here. Okay, so now I will try to fit these things also. When it is all are in, so apply glue, sufficient glue here. Here also you give sufficient glue here as well in this side, so that it will stick here. This should be the box, it have to fix like this, so it should go down. And this surface also should go down. Okay, so this is the way it have to fix. So hold it for a few minutes, it will all will take their shape and the glue will stick properly. Come to horizontal vertical stabilizer. This is first, go for dry fit, remove those part. So you can go for a barbecue sticks, remove the middle part. See, the small part is there, that also remove. So first you cut the 45 degree bevel. Okay, so what I'll do, first I'll cut along this line 45 degree bevel. So I hold my horizontal stabilizer. Place it properly. Then once it you feel okay, go on continuously. Don't cut the upper sticker. Carefully you have to cut. Hold it in this order. Fine. Just you cross check properly. Okay, so almost fine. But if you know, little bit deflection is enough because you are not flying 3D plane, so much deflection is not required. But still clearly you can use also sandpaper for cutting this. If you use sandpaper, you can remove more easily. Okay, fine. You can go for the down deflection whatever you require. Similarly, repeat for rudder also. 145 degree cutting. Now you can observe it is fine, moving properly. Now I go for dry fit first. See, it have to fit in this way. You can observe there is a slot. If you have to press this here, fine. It should be placed in this order. So it's okay. Fine, now we'll go for use the glue. Fit it in this way. Use the glue. Use sufficient glue. Okay, fine. Now can go for fitting. In the side also you have to apply a little bit more. Can use the presser a little bit. Only this side also. Okay, once it is fixed it. And the upper side also you get to give. Okay. Hold it like this, and if you are set screw, you are set square like this for getting the 90 degree perpendicular. Okay, check it, it should be perfectly 90 degree. This is the crucial part. Hold it one hand in this way till it dry like this, and once it dry, you can give more glue in the corner. Hold it for till it will be dry in this way. I have already fitted this horizontal vertical stabilizer. Now we go for fusaelage. So what you have to do? First, properly clean the all the surface, any hot glue or anything is there, because it have to slide in this slot. See, take this horizontal vertical stabilizer, hold one hand to horizontal stabilizer, one hand to vertical stabilizer, slowly slide, don't give any glue in the beginning, so go on sliding slowly. Check whether it is fitting properly or not. Okay, nice. So it is nicely fitting. You can observe. So in this slot I can move this. So it's okay, fine. Everything is fine. So it's fine, it's working nicely. So before giving glue, I will fit the fusaelage wing, because the horizontal stabilizer wing should be parallel. So just remove this. Our horizontal vertical stabilizer is nice. So the dry fit is working nicely. So I will remove this part. hold it once again the way you have insert, in the same way you have to remove. Fine. So what I will do, I will take my wing first. Keep the horizontal vertical stabilizer on one side. Take the wing first. Go on sliding like this. So it have to move in this direction. So what I have to do, there is a two servo horn I have attached that you have to remove, or else you cannot slide properly. So remove this. Keep it one side. Similarly, this also you remove. You can use the servo horn later on also. So this total servo also you can insert after inserting the wing. That is also no problem. So I am keeping these two one side. Next, what I will do, this position I will try to slide. This will only get problem. So it have to go inside like this. So what I will do, I will try to insert in this direction. In this direction. So take the servo. Right now, go on sliding this side. You can see. So first insert the ads like this in one direction, then lift the little bit, lift press is required in this side. Once it go, it will easily move. The slide, because of clear vinyl sheet, it will easily slide. There will be a very less friction. So give like this slightly oscillating motion. Don't press, give more pressure. This is the important point. See, I am giving you a slip oscillating motion. Slowly you proceed. See, this will come this side. So just press it till you get, yes, once you get the another side, you have to slide only. Like this, you have to go and keep your hand proper direction. Don't give any pressure. Just slowly you have to do this part. See, slowly you have to do. When the servo comes, at that point, you have to be careful a little bit. I will know where my servo is touching. Now my servo is touching. So what I have to do, you press this servo. If you are facing any problem, you can take it and you can insert it. I will do one thing. I will take the servo, let it, I will use in the later on stage also. I can insert this, so it will not create any problem. So go on removing the servo. We'll use it later on. So go on sliding. Maybe carefully do. Take your time. Use the table. Hold it. Take your time. If you give more pressure, it will break here. So that precaution you have to take properly. go on sliding like this. One side little bit, then other side. In this way also you can achieve. You can take any barbecue oil at the time of clearance. See, now it come out, no problem at all. Go on pressing in this order only. If you are servo, you know, servo wire. Okay, now I have insert completely. Try to keep exactly at the center. Now you can use at the end. I will use this servo here in the same way what I have told previously. So I slide it completely. So it is in the middle, almost in the middle. You can cross check by a scale. Take your scale. You can measure the distance from here. Both sides you measure the distance like this. See something around this 30 somewhere, 1.8, just give 1 point. And this is 25, so it is 25.5 from this surface. So same I will go this side also along this edge. Okay, so what should the distance we have to check, 25.5 or not? It is slightly less, you can observe it is slightly less. So I will try to move in this way a little bit more. It's fine. Now I can go through once again for checking. It is 2 mm less here. It is 30 and 25.4. here it is. Check like this. 30, just mark the points actually. 30. And from here it is 25.5. Slightly 1 mm this side here you have to move. Check always the center of the wing. Take your time. Don't be hurry. Yeah, this is important point. Once again you have to check what should the distance. It's 30. So 25.8 almost this side. So here it is 30 and 25.5. So slightly to move this side. Okay, now it's fine. Now what I have to do, once it is, you feel that it's correct, once I am cross checking this distance, 30 25.6, so same thing, 30 25.6. okay, it's fine. Now once it is filled, it's correct, you can use your hot gun glue. You can go downward first, apply the glue, give sufficient glue. Along the edges, along this corner point, so that it will stick properly. Okay. Fine. Now my wing is already fit. I will go for fitting the horizontal and vertical stabilizer. So what I will do, I will place my horizontal vertical stabilizer. Okay, so what I have to do, previously I drive it, now I will go for fitting this and I will use the glue also. Yes, fine. Why I kept this, first I insert the wing, because the horizontal stabilizer must be completely parallel to the wing. That is the rule. So one pressing. Okay. Now you check whether it is parallel or not. If any deviation is there, you have to correct. See, it's right almost. But this part is a little bit down. If you observe, in this manner you can observe. This part I feel little bit down this side. So just have at the time of applying the glue, you have to adjust that. Make it the horizontal stabilizer should be completely parallel to the wing. This horizontal stabilizer, this, so you can get by like this. So it's little bit up is required this side. Okay. So what I have to do, while so this side little bit down I feel. So what I will try to do, I will hold it little bit this side. While applying the glue, I hold it little bit upward. So with this position, first I will apply all the edges, the glue, this part, the corner part, right, and this corner part. So one by one you fix this, hold it little bit up like this, and then press, apply the, hold it this order so that it will fix. Hold it little bit time till it stick properly. Okay, now it is dry on this side, and I am checking once again the parallelity between horizontal stabilizer and wing. Okay, it is perfectly parallel now, so I can go for applying the glue in this side also, the downward side also. So hold it like this, give a pressure, downward side also same manner. What I did in upward side, okay. Now coming to the lower wing, same thing, you have to give all. Okay, so my wing is fixed already. Now I will go for fitting of the servo and motor mounting. Okay, I will fit the first motor mounting first. So this is the motor mounting. This is the motor mounting. You will find the center is a marking is given. It is a 6 mm plywood, so it should go like this. It is little bit down. You can see when I fitting this position, a little bit down and rated towards right. Intentionally it is kept so to neutralize the thrust factor. What I will do? I will apply the glue. Now all around, you can observe. Now all around, I am giving the glue. Give sufficient glue so that the motor mount will stick properly. Then press in between this. Also a little bit gap is there. I'm trying to put the glue in that gap also. Then hold it very tightly in all directions like this till it dry. Get it completely. Now after drying, what do you do? Use a clear vinyl sheet which is in the kit. And apply like this. So I will take roughly, it is no such accurate measurement is required. You can take a rectangle shape like this. Fine. Now take the sheet. You can use cello tape also, no problem. Hold it in this manner. Place all around. Now the clear vinyl stick is fixed. Okay. Next step, what you have to do? There is a upper canopy here, and this is the middle one, and this is the lower one. But before going to this, after don't use this in the beginning, because you have to fit the electronics. After that, you can attach all the part. So what I do, this canopy I will prepare. So this will be going to exactly in this shape. So you can use this one first. See, there is a little bit curve here. So to get the curve, I will take something like a this kind of any surface you can take. It have to bend like this. So slowly go on bending in this manner. Slowly apply the pressure so that at one point it should not be bent. Let it be bent at several point, and you will get a curve like this. It have to bend in several point, not a single point. So hold it in this manner and apply the glue. So if you find little bit break here, you can use the glue, no problem. Or else what you do, if any, see, while bending it is slightly break taking place, you take a clear vinyl sheet, right? Both sides you apply. That is best way, because if it break, so I will take two part of clear vinyl sheet. Roughly you cut something around this. No need of any accurate measurement for this. Okay, so see, along with the band only, it is already band. So you can use this clear vinyl sheet like this. if any breakage there, the since this when you attach in the clear vinyl sheet or cello tape, it becomes converted into ductile to brittle. Brittle, initially it is a brittle taste, now it will be in ductile, now it will not break, whatever it is. So because at the time of bending, it will it have break, so I use a clear vinyl sheet. Put it in a curve, right, because it have to fix in the curve format, like this. In this manner. So I will use my glue. Take the glue. Like this, this side, little bit side, this side only you have to fix, so little bit this side and down, okay. Now in the front also you use, that will be attached here. Now slide between the gap, hold it tightly and it should be fixed in this manner. Hold it tightly till it dry, okay. Okay, wait till it dry. This lower lower part here. So for that, first you remove this part. Slightly adjustment is required. So I'm placing this also. Then use the glue. And check whether it is fitting or not properly. So it have to go in this direction. So it have to fit in this direction. So I will take a lot of glue. Then place along this, slide it. Don't give much pressure, just hold it tightly, they will stick each other. Okay, so this part is over. Then there is upper canopy here. Okay, that also you can go for fitting, but it is a, so in this canopy you will find this one. First you have to remove this part here. There is a, you have to take a barbecue sticks to remove the middle part, you can observe. Remove because this is a 50% cut, so manually you have to do these things. The remaining 50% of foam you have to remove through barbecue sticks only. See this line, black line only, it is the slot is cut. So go on removing and clean the slot. Once you find, you will find two plate like this. You can observe here. This part will be go exactly in this manner. So it will fit. See, it will fit in the slot exactly in this manner, and then it will go in this direction. So I will try to fit this two plate piece. So first of all, I have to remove the foam in between the slot. Okay, so I roughly remove all the foam, but you remove properly and try to clean it properly. So this will go in this field here, exactly it will fit in this direction. Then you have to place here in between like this. So any extra is there, you have to cut manually only. So it is the adjustment factor. See, if you did any mistake, accordingly you have to change. That's why this small extra part is given. It will be filled in this manner. This will go like this, and this part will come here. So same thing. This side also, this will be fit in this manner. Okay, so it is like this, it will fit in this manner. So first of all, fit one by one. You take properly clean, it is not clean properly. So I'm trying to remove the extra forms that are present, so that the upper part can slide easily in this slot. Okay, fine. Now you go for one by one. You will do. See, this is the objective. It have to place in this manner. So accordingly you have to bend here a little bit more. Take care, this is once again it is a problem, but you are bending opposite side of the clear blind shape. See here, more bending is required. It have to take this shape, then there will be no pressure to other part. So go on bending like this. Don't bend at one point. See, I'm bending at several point till it take the shape. See, now it is almost take a curve shape. So it will going to fix in this manner. It's fine now. Now I can go for using this thing. See. Now it will fit easily. You can observe. Take your time, little bit time, till you get this kind of shape. So take your glue and insert the side only. Don't give the bottom. It will destroy the clear vinyl sheet or sticker which is provided. So don't use in the here bottom side. Okay, I've taken wrong side, so just wash it properly, because this side I should not attach any glue. So keep it clean. If you have any times miss attachment of glue, you can remove through here the foam only. Fine, actually I have to attach in this way. right? But I put the glue here. This is the wrong things I have done, but you can rectify, because now I will start the glue. This side I supposed to attach the glue. Okay, then hold it in this direction. Hold it in this manner. Hold it for a few minutes. Don't allow the glue, or else it will, if glue will come on this surface, it will tear the sticker. So place it like this and go on repeating for this also. Already insert the glue the both the part. Now next, this is the lower part which we have to insert here in this direction. So before we do this, what there is a magnet I have to place for holding this. So this is the four magnet you will find in the kit. This is the small magnet. So what I will do, I will place somewhere in the middle like this. So for that, you take small part of the very small part, exactly in the middle somewhere, and it is the sizes, it should be size of the magnet where you are placing, like this size. So I have to remove that small part. Try to remove this small part. It is not there initially, but according to the position of your magnet, don't break that. Later on you will press once again this part. So this part you keep it. Clear this hole properly so that the magnet should attack the other side. Now see, this is the magnet and this is the slot I have taken. Now I have to press in this way. So before that, you put like this, it have to place. Take a screwdriver or something and place it. If it is, take a baby stick. If you take screwdrivers, that will attract. Place it, should be completely flat. Hold it to one side and apply the magnetic other side like this. Fine, now it is okay. So how I placed this, the magnet is there, not visible properly, but this will be useful for holding this canopy. Then you use little glue here to fix up, and the small part which you have taken, you have to place it here in the same way. Then just place it the small part, then take a clear vinyl sheet and cut accordingly a small piece like this and place here. Now there is no chance that the magnet will come out. So right now there is a magnet. This magnet will be hold the clear vinyl sheet here. Now I can place in this way. So take a glue all around this side also, and a little bit this side also. Now hold it in this order. fine. Now it is fitted nicely. So wait till it dry. Keep it this outside. Take this three link. The hole is there. This one by one. Don't put all three together. Right. Then it should be installed like this. So take your screw. Like this. All four screw use. Based on after first flying, medium flying, you can cross check where how much thrust angle is required. Based on you can use the remaining washer. So you can use the screwdriver. Go on holding like this. Okay. With the along the put the washer here. Put the washer. You can use the nose plier. If you are unable to assess, do one thing. If I unable to assess, you can cut it more little bit, because I am feeling little bit unable to assess. So I am cutting little bit more. The same amount of saffron is used for the opening of gate later on stage. Now you put the washer first. Now I can able to put the washer. Now see, I have installed all the screws. Go on installing all the screws. Make it tight. Once it's fixed, go to the upper side. Take a washer. I will take a washer and place in the screw. Okay. You have to place the screw, then use a nut bolt. Okay. So like that, I can repeat for other three screws. Screws here. You can tight it all the screw. You can use this nose plier. You can keep it one side, and with this help of a screwdriver, you can tight it like this. Hold and tight. Similarly, this side also you can keep all the screw. You can tight. Like this you can tight, because washer is that the screw will not come out. So my motor is also installed. Now I will install the servo control for this. You already I removed the form. Same thing for little part of this. So press it in this manner and remove the foam, what are there? Then place your control horn like this. It should be tight fit, accessible. Then similarly, you can have to do for rudder and elevator. I will use the glue. Yeah, I'm using the glue. So place sufficient glue, then use your control horn, place it like this. Similarly, for this side also, I am putting the glue.
can use extra glue sticks. So the glue is not coming. I toss the glue and then use this control ball and place all around like this. See, little bit glue is provided in the side also, so that the clear vinyl sticker will remain in contact with this, like this. And any other extra glue, if fall on any surface, you can remove it like this. You can remove any other extra glue. Fine. In the corner also, you place little bit glue so that at the later on stage it will not come out. Just also use extra glue so that it will not come out. Now coming to the rudder and elevator, here place it in this manner. See, first you choose how it, this have to go through. You have to access to this part. So there is a big two servo rod are provided. One is little bit bigger, you choose the bigger one and it have to place in this manner, right? So it have to go like this. So I'll fix the control horn somewhere here. So there are two control horn with the linkage stopper are provided, you can see. So you place here one very close to the surface. This is a mark. There's a mark like this. Remove the form. Same way, you have to do always the control horn or wherever you are attaching. You remove the form little bit. Then insert it. Like this. Here is the control horn I'm testing. Okay, so it have to go completely inside the tape to see, and then extra glue on this side, and also this side. And a little bit extra pressure so the glue will come properly. So I am placing this somewhere here. Hold it for a few minutes till it dry off. Next, you place the rudder. See, rudder and elevator are in opposite side. So always see, don't place the elevator this side because I have to hold it in this direction. So wherever cut this side for if you observe from rear end, for elevator, it is left hand side, you have to place the control horn, and for rudder, you have to place in right hand side the control horn. So put it in the downward little bit, because if you put above here, the elevator and rudder push rod will cross each other, they will touch each other, it will be a problem. So go a little bit down here. So what I'll do, I'm going in the downward axis a little bit, and I'll place my control horn here near somewhere here, downward a little bit, so that I can assess in this manner. Okay, I can put the control horn like this. Okay.
see the where the rod will come. In that way you have to place somewhere here. So just give a mark here and then you remove the foam. This part you have to remove the foam. Then this part you remove the foam. See, cross check once again, it have to go in this manner. And the I place the control hole in downward direction. If it is in the reverse direction, you just remove it by removing like this. Give it a turn. You can place by your own also. This is not a big issue. But initially you have to insert this. See, and then reverse it. Whatever direction you want, in that direction you place. See, now if I place, I will attach my control horn in the top direction so that accessibility will be easy. Right? So I'll put the glue gun once again, keep it parallel to this little bit, and use completely. Okay, press it. Fine, just I'm holding to have more glue. Then you press all around. Keep your transmitter, everything away from this glue. Once it is fixed, you can take apart and you can use the some extra glue in this side. And same thing you have to do on this side also. Fine. Now my all servo are attached. Hold it a little bit time. Okay, my all servo are attached. My all control horn are also attached. Now I will go on attaching the push rod. We'll go on attaching the push rod. So here we have four push rod. You'll find two larger one, one for elevator, and one for rudder, and two smaller one for Elnor. So I'll start with the two Elnor. So what you have to do? Just take it down. You first install this Elnor servo rod like this. You take again somewhere here, upper one, and go gentle pressure to move it this side. You're not going. You what you do? You take your candle, take candle, and light it little bit. Use okay. You hot this rod little bit hot, then it will be easy to insert the push rod into the control horn. In that way it will be hit, so it will try to burn the periphery of the control horn. So it is so hot. Now I will try to push it in this side. It will be, now you see it will gone easily, it will go, right? It is fixed. So Similarly, you repeat for this side also. Just make it hot a little bit. The same direction you try to place. Okay, so do the same things wherever the upper hole is there. At that point you try to insert. Okay, so fine. Now I have inserted my two control push rod into the control hole surface, you can observe. The next step what you have to do, you have to place the servo horn like this. We have two servo horn we removed in early. So I will take this two screw and two servo horn. So here you will find leakage stopper you have to place. This already I placed, but previously you will find, if you have a new, you will find this one. And this leakage stopper for rudder and elevator is already there in a control hole. It has some objective. Intentionally I placed in the control horn, but it is in servo horn. See, for L now. So what I do, I first place my push rod, let it be inset like this. Then you take this servo, and already it is 0 degree trim is there and it is center. So I will try to place it exactly at the center somewhere here. Right, make it perpendicular to the surface. Then you insert. But before that you screw off, this is the screw. You screw up the servo horn. Be accessible easily. Okay, so it is now tight. Now place it like this, then take a clear vinyl sheet, it is provided in the kit. See, you can take a clear vinyl sheet and place it like this. So this is cut it somewhere, some part like this, and attach this part like this. You attach. Now the objective, I'll not be using any glue to attachment of the servo, is that at any stage I can remove the servo if any damage is there. If glue I attach, means I have to break the foam. That is, that's why I am. So repeat the same things. Now how you center off, see, repeat the same thing for this also. So here the opening and closing part you will see. Here this is the part which we have taken, and we will use a clear vinyl sheet I cut. So take that sheet and attach from beginning like this. This part and place it here exactly somewhere here. Now you can observe it will fix. So whenever you want to open, you can open like this. So there is a another part I will place under clear vinyl sheet by folding in this manner. So what I will do, I will take and I will cut 45 degree, slightly 45 degree like this, so that the folding will be easy. Fine. Now the folding will be easy, no obstruction will come. So I will take a clear vinyl sheet, same thing, small part you will take. Like this, small part you take. Then use the sheet in this manner. Hold it along like this. Okay, so that will allow in this manner you place to fix it in this bottom side also, right? Now I can observe it is fixed very nicely moving. For more easy way assessment or automatic attachment, what you have to do, you can use a magnet here. I will use a magnet here so that you can place it, or can you this way also, if you place it's no problem because the wind will flow in this direction and it will not open. Or else you can give a magnet also between them. Okay, fine. So we'll move to there is a motor mount canopy. You can see we'll find this motor mount canopy like this. Yeah, here I remove all the middle part and you'll get a shape like this. It have to placed in this manner and it will be placed here. So first we'll prepare this motor mount canopy. So come to the glue, use the glue. See, just bend. Before that, what you will do, just bend this two side, because there is a curve here. This have to fit along the curve. So go on, bend slightly along like this. You can take any rod like or a pen, hold it in this direction, hold it little bit curve initially you leave. The reason that this curve will exactly fix in this curve, so it have to fix in this manner. So this is the position of fitting, you can observe. So what I will do, I will put the glue all around this side first, all four corner side. Use lot of glue. I can use my hand to put the glue this side and this side, and also on the bottom side, all the corner side. You use all the corner side also glue, so that it will not come out. This side also. Fine. Now attach one by one. Go on attaching this first two. In this manner, once you feel happy, you can go for attaching the other two in this manner. The same thing you have to do for this. Go and attach this part. So you finally will obtain this kind of shape. So carefully you have to do this part particularly. Okay, so this part have to fix here, this part have to fix here, the corners, the borders. So this way we will obtain this part. One fixing, use some extra glue in the corner so that it will not come out. Okay, so hold it for few minutes, all will be stick together. And the shapes will be come like this in the font, and below will it like this. Hold it till all the glue stick properly. Actually called is front cover is prepared. So you have to install like this. For that, what you have to do, there is a yellow color clear vinyl stick is there. So you just cut down to a proper size and use all around. See, I'm cutting down all the heat. You will make it two part so that it will go all around. And remove the all white part in the clear vinyl sheet or the sticker provided. Just make it, fold it two part. Fold it here in the middle. Right. Then you cut along this line. You can use this blade, cutting blade. So here you can use this. Cut it properly. So cut here. Okay, so here you can observe this is channel number 1. It is 100, this is my lower throat. It, now it is 100%, as you can observe. I have to reduce to a little bit, coming to a dual rate, I will reduce to around 40%. So you can observe, I have to go up to 40%, is nice. And expo you can keep around 30%, so I will change to 30% expo. Okay, now I will go for same thing for channel number 2 also. Same, you can keep all 40 and 30%. So then go for long press. Now you can set for lower position. This is go for 12 rate once again. Now I will keep, you can observe, if I go to dual rate, my channel number 1 is set to 40 and 30%. Now if I go for higher position set also, I will switch down. I will find 160. So for higher position, you can keep channel number all, you can keep around 60 or 70, it's up to you. You can keep 60 or 70 or 80, how you are flying and what is the level of flying. I am keeping at present 60% throw, and expo same thing, you can keep around 30%. Okay, so same thing you can repeat for channel 2 and 3. Now the last step what I have to check the CG. So for that I have to place all the servo wire in proper position. See, the ESC, the all wires should be placed properly. So I'm removing the battery first. I'm trying to place the ESC first, right? So this is the ESC. I'm taking out the ESC in that side so that it will get air, right? So ESC in the top side, keeping here. Then for battery, now place the battery in the position, right? You can use a magnet here, up to you. You can use a magnet here to hold. Next step, you put the upper canopy. Here also you can use one magnet. So like this, one magnet I given. So you can place another magnet here and place in this direction. Okay, so place it completely, it should go down. Fine, now it is correct. Now if you have to checking of CG is an important point. See here, two red mark are there, red circle. So if you hold your finger in between this red mark somewhere here, little bit nose heavy you prefer, like this. You can observe with two finger it should be perfect platform, but it little bit nose heavy is preferable, like this nose down. So little bit nose down is preferable. Okay, so everything is set. Now you can go for flying.
just 8x4.5 blade, and the surface are all like curved, so it looks like a bar, so I name it the wing bar. The all control surface I kept around 40% is lower throw and 60% high throw. You can go for 35% is and 75% is up to your flying skill, but you can act as a, also act as a trainer. So I will try to put into air. Yeah, you can fly very close to the ground like this. You can fly very close to the ground. Even you can. That's the ground. I just touch the ground and you will go off.